disorder?
I've had a bit of it, yeah, and I think part of it's psychosomatic, but I don't want to let on that it might be waning, because it's great when I kind of go bacon sandwich now and it sort of happens.
Oh, does it?
Yeah. I'm going to use up a few more vouchers.
Absolutely. Yeah. I always, my friend used to say, oh, my baby wants a cup of tea.
Yeah.
And just
and
to get everything
three,
done
just to make sure, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Covered.
Get them running around. No, it's good to see you looking so blooming and happy, because last time you came in, you had a real change of a period of your life, weren't you? Sort of one relationship ending, new things happening in your life, and now it all seems to be a lot smoother.
Well, I think that was kind of, probably when I came, it was kind of the end of that, really, I think, during the summer and everything. And it was a really good time to write an album, really, because I sort of had just so much to write about. But yeah, no, I mean, everything's great. Yeah, I'm really, I feel like my horizon is very broad and exciting. So.
Yeah, brilliant. Talking of broad, you've got to start thinking about how to dress, because you're such a style icon, aren't you?
And
you're going to have that little, tummy.
You're going to be very
Not
broad.
That you are now. You've got a very discreet designer bump there. Like
designer bump. Oh, good. I've had it measured. Apparently, it's all right. Yeah, I don't know what the etiquette is at this stage. If I'm supposed to be sort of celebrating it, or still trying to pretend it's not there. But luckily, a lot of my clothes are adaptable, I think, and I'm going to try not to buy a whole new wardrobe just for these next sort of 9 months or so, but
yeah,
it's tough not to.
Look at Gwyneth Paltrow and Chris Martin as well.
Know,
very sweet pictures.
They
just hold it up there, having a lovely time. They just seen the first scan, know that everything's all right, which is also a great relief, isn't
it's
it,
a
for
big
any
deal,
new parents?
Yeah.
Huge deal in that terms of that. Is there more pressure, do you think, if you have got high profile jobs having a baby? Is there a different sort of pressure, do you think?
Well, I think just that natural worry that every mother has, and you know, I'm sure it happens on some scale, even if you're not in the public eye, but just of wanting everything to be all right. And, you know, I mean, once you are past sort of 12 weeks, yeah, you are in the second stage and the risk of miscarriage and everything is severely diminished. But, you know, you just want to know you've got a healthy baby and you don't know that till, you know, it's born and everything. So I think you just feel kind of, yes, I'm excited, but I've also got...
Keeping everything crossed
some...
at the same time.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah. Now, you've got your single as well, I Won't Change You, coming out. I think we can have a little look at it. Should I have a look at it first and chat about it?
It's no reason to go crazy. Boy, you can always count on me. For better or for worse, I will always put you first. Now that I have found you, you've changed my life. Cause you're the one who showed me I had everything right. Whenever...
So you've got it all covered there. You've got a bit of blonde, bit of brown hair, bit of red hair.
Yes, yeah. For, trying to woo my chap, trying to get as many 3 minutes out of the speed dating as possible.
Ah, brilliant. Mm.
Yeah, so it works.
Does it?
In the video, yes.
Yeah.
Do get him.
Okay, all right. No, it's being released on December the 29th, isn't it? Up against Victoria Beckham's single. Which is just going to get everybody going again like it did two years ago, isn't it, about
the
competition.
When I found out, I was a bit like, oh, great. Not because I've got anything bad to say about her, but rather more because of that fact, really. It's kind of like, I feel like a huge disappointment because I get asked about it and I don't know, I mean, I haven't...
Do you have any choice over when things are released, or is that all the record company?
Not hugely, actually. Mm. I mean, a lot of it's to do with what's happening with your own stuff. I mean, if you've had a single out, you have to wait till the radio stations are ready to start playing the new one, not the old one, and all that kind of thing. So this was just the week that suited it. And to be honest, when I first heard rumours that she was releasing a song, I thought it probably wouldn't happen because things move around all the time.
Mm.
But, you know, it's got to come out the same day as someone, and I just hope that she's not getting too sick of it as well, because it is... You know, there's not very much we can say on the subject.
No.
I don't think we've got anything bad to say.
And also, you won last time because you pipped it to the post, didn't you? So you could be magnanimous in victory.
Well, you know what? I'm really like, I'm either very competitive, not competitive, I'm not sure, because I don't like people feeling sorry for me if I don't do well. So with the last time, I always didn't want to think of it like beating her to number one. I just wanted to think it was my first number one, and that was a huge thing. But if it was a number two, that would have been my biggest hit as well. And I don't want people going, oh, shame on you for getting number two. That still would have been brilliant.
It is strange, isn't it, about all that chart positioning? So some of the best songs of all time never made it to number one. And
sure.
I know there was I was reading up a bit in the press about your album, which is supposed to be, compared to other things you've done, low in the charts. I mean, is it all just nonsense, or does it
affect actually,
you?
The album's doing exactly the same as the last album was doing
at
the same stage. So I don't know. The great thing about albums is they've got a while to prove themselves.
Mm.
And you can keep sending out little ambassadors with the singles until people have heard enough and decide whether they want to own it or not. And I don't know what you're like with albums, but I don't buy things after one song either. I like to know what I'm getting from
my album. And then you get a bit of interest as gets surrounds it.
Yeah.
You think, oh, I will get that
now. And if you've heard a couple of songs and you like both, and then you're like, okay, I'll go for it.
Yeah.
It's quite, you know, they're not cheap.
It builds up gradually.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Okay, well, look, it sounds like it's a great time for you. Good luck with everything.
Thank you very much.
Excellent. And you're coming back to perform, aren't you, a bit later on today?
I am, yeah.
Brilliant.
My musicians
we'll see that. Yeah, they're all getting ready over there. Brilliant. Blooming she is, you see. I knew I was going to be broody by the end of today's programme.
Yeah, all the best over the next few months. It's just the greatest privilege, isn't it?
Yeah, I can't wait. I'm really properly excited.
Right, we're going to send people away to Australia now, family holiday. This is the question.